breathing you. Out of Australia, we Sleep Makes Waves were probably one of those bands like that just blew my mind. I think they bridged that gap between that sort of post-rock and modern post-rock and progressive. So we did a tour with them back in April, and admittedly, didn't know what to expect, wasn't a fan of that sort of atmospheric stuff, but they're awesome. Like, it is just, it's so emotional, but it's hooky and it's riffy, and it's the best time. For that sort of music, it's actually really exciting. You know, like they throw a little bit of that crazy fruity prog stuff in there. Yeah, you know, they'll spicy, a little spicy moment at the end of the song. They're really exciting to listen to. I mean, like their last album is just, it's incredible.
I think their energy on stage has really ramped up in the last 3 years as well. I remember a couple of years ago, they moved around a little bit, but that tour, they were just, it was.
I had a friend of mine describe them as the best interpretive dance band they've ever seen. Because there is no vocals, it's all instrumental. And those boys can dance.
Yeah.
They can groove.
Very dancey boys.
Very wiggly.
I'd have to go, once again, biased because I get to see so many facets of these bands, but I loved working with Voyager, and I was already a fan of their last couple of albums, and hearing their new one before it came out, it was awesome because I know their personality. I kind of already have that at the front of my mind when I'm watching them play, and getting into them as a live band first. But like, they'll be getting up on things on stage and like full on metal faces, and Simone's like this 2 foot tall girl who absolutely shreds, 2 foot, 3 foot, anyway, quite small. And she's like doing metal face like, ah, while she's shredding, and
she
I'm just like,
the best metal face.
Yes, more of that. And then like the keytar aspect and total confidence in that. And so I'm a big fan of Voyager.
Best covers medleys, I think, on in a live setting as well. They absolutely somehow smooshed together such a...
It's a tradition. It's a traditional thing with this band. They'll go up on stage and you'll hear this riff start which heralds the beginning of the medley. And then suddenly you've heard everything from like Korn to like Darude Sandstorm in 20 seconds, and you're just like, what just happened? But yep, Voyager, 100%.
It's tough to, if we're going with three, it's really tough to narrow it down because there's so much quality going on at the moment. I think personally, I would definitely pick the two that the boys have mentioned. And I think for me, the third one is Chaos Divine out of Perth. David Anderton's voice is one of the best rock voices in Australia, and metal voices for that matter. The boys write really great material. Love, you know, it's compact, but it's prog. I had a blast touring with them a couple of years ago around Australia, and I can't speak highly enough of them. But yeah, I mean, there's so many amazing bands. You know, the firmly entrenched Australian bands and some of the up and coming ones as well. You know, there's a lot of young talent.